Let us continue our topic, carbon and its compounds. We are discussing about IUPAC rules, in which I already told you one rule. Okay, what is the rule number one? Rule number one is telling that, right, so it is indicating a pairing chain, so length of the chain, right? For example, if you take an organic compound, so how many number of carbons in it? So if you want to tell that, so that is length of the chain. Okay, rule number one is indicating length of the chain. So how do you know that? So length of the chain means that, for example, total number of carbons you have to count, right? Total number of carbons. Then like that only you have to consider length of the chain. And rule number two, lowest sum rule. So already I told you rule number one. And rule number two is lowest sum rule. So after identifying, so length of the chain, after identifying length of the chain, that is parent chain. So we have to give numbering for the parent chain. So either you can start from left to right, or you can start from right to left, right? So in giving numbering, so you can start from left to right, or so right to left, or from top to down also, right? But remember, right, the alkyl group should get the lowest possible number, right? So if there is any substituent present on the parent chain, then it should take lowest number. I already told you one example for that. For example, if you have a compound like this, CH3, CH2, CH2 and CH3 like this. And here, so from where we can start numbering, either from right to left or from left to right. So here, in this case, we have to start only from right to left. Why? Because if you give numbering from right to left, so then it is 1, it is 2, it is 3 and 4 and 5 like this. Or if you start numbering from like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here, this is the position of alkyl group. This is the position of alkyl group. And here, suppose if you start from left to right, then what is the position of alkyl group? That is 4. If you start from right to left, then what is the position of alkyl group? That is 2. So 2 is the lowest number. So that's why its name will become, so 2, at second carbon we have methyl, at second carbon we have methyl, and the root word is total we have 5 carbons, that is nothing but pent, that is nothing but pent, and all are single bonds, then suffix is an, so total, so 2 methyl pentane is the right answer. Suppose if you consider from left to right, then it will become 4 methyl pentane, but that is wrong. 4 methyl. Why? Because condition is, so the methyl group or any alkyl group should take least priority, should take least number, that is the second point. Okay, here also there is one more point. Okay, so one important point is there. So that is, suppose if compound having unsaturation, suppose if compound having unsaturation, then you should not consider this rule again. Should not consider the position of the alkyl group, just only you have to consider unsaturation. For example, in case of unsaturation, if unsaturation is present, okay, so it takes first priority. For example, suppose I have CH2 double bond, CH, CH2, CH, CH3 and CH3. In general, by considering second rule, what you can think, we have to start from right to left. Why? Because here it is taking a second carbon we have methyl. But if you write like that, it will be wrong. Why? Because in this compound we have unsaturation. Unsaturation means that double bond or triple bond. So here double bond is present. Whenever double bond is present, okay, irrespective of the position of alkyl group, right? Irrespective of the position of alkyl group, we have to give numbering from, we have to start the numbering from the unsaturation only. So unsaturation must take first priority. So that's why here numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 5 like that. So the name of the compound at fourth carbon we have methyl. So that's why here I'm writing 4 methyl. Here I'm writing 4 methyl. And here, so 4 methyl at first carbon we have unsaturation. So that's why. So at first carbon unsaturation is present. So and so total number of carbons, total number of carbons 5. So that's why it is faint. Faint. Okay, 4 methyl. Or you can write like this. Okay, simply you can write like this. 4 methyl. Okay. Faint 1 ene. At first carbon we have ene. Ene is the suffix. Ene is the suffix. Right? Ene is the suffix of alkene. There is alkene. Then the last three words is so ene. Ene. Right? So this is second row. Fine. And let us see third row. Okay. Third row is okay. Uses of di, tri, tetra, and so on. Right? So this rule actually, so when we have use, right? So whenever the compound has same number, okay, whenever the compound has same number of identical alkyl groups, same number of identical alkyl groups are present. Same number of identical alkyl groups are present. So then we have to use di. Suppose if carbon length, if carbon chain having okay two alkyl groups, then we have to use di. Okay. So if carbon chain having three identical alkyl groups, then we have to use 3. If it is having 4 alkyl groups, then we have to use 4. Like that. So we have to use. So whenever we have to use di, tri, tetra. So whenever the carbon chain is having okay more number of identical alkyl groups, then only we have to use okay this kind of rule. For example, okay, let me take CH3 and CH3 here and CH3 here, right? And CH2 and CH2, CH3, like that, right? Again, from this, what is the parent chain here? This is the longest chain, rule number one, longest chain we are selecting. This is parent chain, right? And this parent chain, we have to start numbering, rule number two. From here, we have to start numbering. So either from left to right or from right to left. So left to right, right? Because if you start from left to right, then alkyl groups, these alkyl groups will take lowest number. So that's why we are telling, we are starting from here. And 1, 3, 4, and 5, 6, like this. And here. At second carbon, we have 1 methyl. At third carbon, we have 1 more methyl group here. So that's why the name of this compound is 2, 3. 2, 3. 2, 3 means that at second carbon and third carbon. So how many? So this is CH3, this is also CH3. Identical alkyl groups are present. Identical. These are identical alkyl groups. Those are not different. So those are identical. Methyl and methyl. Identical alkyl groups. That's why. So two methyl groups are there. That's why we have to use. There is two that we have to use. Di. And di methyl. Then it is dimethyl. So length of the carbon chain, 6 carbons. Then root word hex. All are single bonds. Suffix N. All are single bonds. Suffix N. 2, 3 dimethyl. Hexane is the number N. Right? For example. Okay. For example. Here I want to 3, 4. 2, 2. 3, 3. Tetra alkyl, hexane. Suppose he has given a compound like this, then how can you write its structure? For example, and so here total how many carbons we have? Length of the carbon chain. So here X is the root word. First of all, we have to identify root word, and the root word is X. Then write 6 carbons here to get the structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons here. At 2, 2, which means that at 2, 2 positions, alkyl groups are present. So here alkyl is nothing but tetramethyl. Suppose let it some tetramethyl.
with the groups. At the same time, 3, 3, a third carbon also we have, a third carbon also we have methyl groups, and the remaining bonds are okay balanced by the hydrogen atoms. So always okay, 4 bonds should be present around carbon atom. Like that we have to balance with the number of hydrogen atoms. Then so this is the structure of 2 carbon 2. Okay, 2 carbon 2. Okay, 3 carbon 3. Start numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2 carbon 2, 3 carbon 3, 3 carbon 3. How many total? 4. If there are 4 methyl groups are present, then it is tetra. That is tetra. So that's right. Like that, we have to give numbering based on the number of identical alkyl group. This is the rule number 3. And coming to the rule number 4. Alphabetical arrangement. Suppose rule number 4. We can use rule number 4 in the case of different alphabetical arrangement. So when we have to use this? So whenever we have different alkyl groups are present in the parent chain. Different alkyl groups are present in the parent chain. Right? Not identical. So we are having different alkyl groups. Different alkyl groups. For example, I am taking a compound like this. CH3, CH2 and CH. CH2, CH3 and CH, CH3, like this, right? And here, for example, this is length of the carbon chain. Then, let it give numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you start from here, so the alkyl group here, CH2CH3 is also you can also write as C2H5. C2H5 name ethyl group. The name of the C2H5 ethyl group. Got my point? The name of the ethyl group C2H5. And this is methyl. This is ethyl. CH2CH3 is nothing but you can write simply C2H5. C2H5 means that ethyl group. CH2CH3 or C2H5 will give the same name, right? So here we have ethyl and here we have methyl. So methyl group presented second carbon, ethyl group presented third carbon. So what do you think? So first we have to give numbering for the second carbon. If you do like that, so it will be wrong answer. Why? Because here, so alkyl groups are different. This ethyl, this methyl, then we have to use alphabetical order. So which group we have to start first? So in that case, we have to give, so we have to assign alphabetical order for this. And here, so E is the first letter. So alpha, if you see alphabetical letter, so E first, M last. So that's why. So first we have to consider E. That is, at third position we have 3 ethyl. At second position we have 2 methyl. At second position we have 3 methyl. Ethyl, methyl, both are different alkyl groups. So then total number of carbon 6. So then hexane. Then the name of the compound hexane. So in this case we have to use, that is the rule number 4. Next, bond is present, triple bond is present, but from which we have to start numbering. So that is the question mark, right? So here the competition is between double bond versus triple bond. Let it double bond versus triple bond. So if double bond and triple bond are in competition, if they are at equal distance, then you should give first priority for double bond. You should give first priority for double bond. So first priority goes to double bond. DB means double bond. If they are at unequal distance, then first priority goes to triple bond. Like that. For example, let us see one example for that. CH2 double bond, CH here, and CH2, CH2, C triple bond CH.
And here if you can observe clearly, so at this double bond, so this double bond is terminal for this chain, this double bond is also terminal. They are at equal distance. So double bond is present at this side, so triple bond is present at this side. So equal distance they are maintained. So then, so we have to start numbering from alkene. First priority goes to alkene. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. Unlike that, suppose we have a compound like this, CH3, CH double bond CH, CH2, C triple bond CH. But here you can see here, right, C triple bond CH, okay, it is at a terminal position, it is at a terminal, okay, it is, at one side double bond is present, but here triple bond is present, but here it at the middle, so we have, so double bond, in this case we have to give numbering for the alkyne, we have to start numbering from alkyne, right, so like that, we have to start numbering, okay, when there are double bond and triple bond are in combination. And rule number 6, if functional group is present, FG means functional group is present, along with double bond or triple bond, then you should not consider all these rules, we have to consider only functional group. For example, we have a compound like CH2 double bond, CH2, COOH. So what in general what we think? So we have to start from, so unsaturation, that is from double bond. But that is wrong answer. Okay. And here we have a functional group that is acid. This is the acid functional group. Then we have to start numbering from this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's where. Like that, we have to start numbering like this by using this. So these are the main guidelines, or these are the main rules we have to use by giving numbering. Whenever we are giving numbering for the organic compound, we have to consider all these points. Okay, we have to keep in our mind all these points. Okay, those are said to be IUPAC rules, right? And next topic. Carbon compounds, organic compounds, or you can call it as carbon compounds. In general, carbon compounds undergo four types of chemical reactions. One is combustion reactions. Second one is oxidation reactions. Third one is addition reactions. And fourth one is substitution reactions. Okay, right? Let us see first what are combustion reactions. So combustion reactions means that the process of burning carbon compounds, right? For example, suppose let it some wood is present like this. Okay, suppose if wood is present, if you burn wood, what is happening? Some smoke will come out, right? Smoke contains carbon dioxide, right? And whenever we are burning, some heat energy liberated from that system. In the same manner, if there is any carbon compound is present, when you burn that, then what is happening? Then it is undergo burning. So then it gives carbon dioxide. It releases carbon dioxide. For example, carbon compound having carbon. So whenever we are treating in air present, carbon will react with air. In air, oxygen is present. In the presence of oxygen, only burning takes place. Then, so what is happening? So burning of oxygen, then what is happening? Carbon will combine with oxygen, then it releases carbon dioxide. Along with that, it releases some energy. That is heat energy. Suppose my carbon compound is ethane. Ethane formula C2H6. Then if it is reacting with 7 moles of oxygen and 2 moles of ethane will react together to give 4 moles of carbon dioxide plus 6 moles of H2O plus energy. 6 moles of H2O, along with that it releases some heat energy like that. Right? So my carbon compound is alcohol. This is also carbon compound, functional group alcohol. Then if it is reacting with oxygen, then also it releases
then also, so if it is reacting with 3 moles of O2, then also it releases 2 moles of CO2 and total here, so 3 moles of H2O plus energy, some energy will be liberated.
Can you balance? So 3 is 6 and 7, right? 4 plus 3 is 7. Okay, so it was balanced. Right? Like that. So these are the combustion reactions. So what is combustion reaction? So whenever we are burning, carbon compound in the presence of oxygen, it releases carbon dioxide plus some cases water. Water means that okay, it is present as moisture. Okay, it is present as moisture, then releases some heat energy like this. So that's that is the other kind of reaction. In the same way, suppose if you have petrol, you can ask me that. Petrol or diesel also containing, so diesel also containing carbon. Whenever you burn, then also along with the carbon dioxide, then also it releases, along with the carbon dioxide, it releases oxides of sulfur, like sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide. In the same way, oxides of nitrogen, like nitrous oxide, nitrogen dioxide, like that. But when compared to carbon dioxide, so these are very harmful. So they will destroy environment, they will destroy. That's why, so whenever we are using vehicles more, then which means that we are using petrol more. Whenever we are using petrol more, it releases SO3, NO2. That means that it is spoiling our environment. That is about the combustion reaction. And next topic, oxidation. So oxidation means that, so what is meant by oxidation? Oxidation means that addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen is called as oxidation reaction. For example, suppose here I am taking an alcohol CH3CH2OH. The name of this compound, two carbons with, so ethyl alcohol. This is ethyl alcohol, right? Ethyl alcohol. Whenever we are treating ethyl alcohol with alkene KMnO4, this is oxidizing reagent. KMnO4 is a oxidizing reagent. Or we can use K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7. You can use KMnO4 or you can use potassium dichromate. Then what is happening? Initially, it is converted to CH3CH2OH is converted to CH3CHO. Removal of hydrogen takes place here, right? And acetaldehyde, the name of the compound is acetaldehyde. If it is undergo further oxidation, again if you repeat this reaction, that is, again by using alkene KMnO4, or K2Cr2O7, then again it is undergo oxidation, then it is converted to CH3COOH. This is acetic acid. If you observe here, here removal of hydrogen takes place, and here addition of oxygen takes place. Here addition of oxidation takes place. In this same reaction, I have explained addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen also, right? So this is called as oxidation reaction. And next reaction, addition reaction, right? So the condition for addition reaction, if you want to proceed an addition reaction by any organic compound, definitely the organic compound should have double bond or triple bond, right? For example, right? And here, for example, I have a compound like this, HC triple bond CH. So this is alkyne. The name of this one, acetylene, alkyne. Whenever I am treating with the hydrogen gas, so in the presence of some catalyst, nickel as the catalyst here. So nickel, in the nickel metal acting as a catalyst here. What is meant by catalyst? It doesn't participate in the reaction, but it enhances rate of reaction. It increases rate of reaction. Catalyst will increase or decrease the rate of reaction, but in this case, it increases rate of reaction. So then, what is happening? Whenever I am treating with the hydrogen gas, so one pi bond, here you can see, this is sigma bond, this is pi bond, this is also pi bond. One sigma bond is present, two pi bonds are present. How many pi bonds are present? Two pi bonds are present. Then, so whenever with one mole of hydrogen gas, so So one pi bond will be broken up. One pi bond will be broken up. So then, so after breaking pi bond, here we can add one hydrogen atom. Here we can add one hydrogen atom, and here we can add another hydrogen atom. One hydrogen is added to this carbon. One hydrogen is added to this carbon. Then it will become CH2 double bond. So this is okay. This is addition of hydrogen. In the same manner. So if you repeat the reaction, that is again with another mole of H2 in the presence of nickel, then what will be happening? Again this pi bond will be broken up. Now one hydrogen will be added to this carbon, and the another hydrogen will be added to this carbon. Finally, we get CH3, which means that alkene is converted to alkane. Like that, addition reactions are taking place. So, next topic, what are substitution reactions? Substitution reactions are nothing but the displacement of one atom by another atom. Suppose, okay, if you observe, so after me, some sar will come here, which means that I am displaced by some other sar. Okay, and after some time, so that sar will be replaced by another sar. Like that, what is happening? Replacement of sars are going on here. In the same manner, replacement of atoms are going in chemical reactions. But the best example for this one, substitution reaction means that, okay, displacement of one atom or group of atoms by another atom or group of atoms. Right? For example, here I have a compound CH4. Okay, and I am treating with chlorine in the presence of sunlight. In the presence of sunlight. Then what is happening? In the presence of sunlight, so all hydrogens, okay, will be replaced by the chlorine atoms. All hydrogens will be replaced by the chlorine atoms. For example, suppose one hydrogen, one chlorine will react together and will come out as HCl, will come out as HCl remaining. So one hydrogen has gone from the CH4, then so there are three hydrogen atoms, then CH3, one chlorine is replaced by one chlorine atom. And one hydrogen and one chlorine atom will react together to form as a HCl. In the same manner, so this is the name of this compound is methyl chloride. In the same manner, if you take methyl chloride, again if you repeat the same reaction, that is when you react with Cl in the presence of again sunlight, then one more hydrogen from CH3 will be replaced by the Cl, then it will become CH2 Cl2 plus HCl. If you carry the same reaction with the Cl2 in the presence of sunlight, then all hydrogens will be replaced by chlorine atoms. Then so CCl4, okay, and here subserve CCl4, so all four hydrogen atoms are replaced by this. If you repeat the same reaction, you will get the, so this kind of reaction is called as substitution reaction. What is meant by substitution reaction? The displacement of an atom or group of atoms by another atom or group of atoms is called as substitution reactions. This is organic compounds, some important organic compounds. So those are nothing but here ethyl alcohol or ethanol, or we can call it as ethyl alcohol. The structure of the compound C2H5OH. Structure of the compound C2H5, ethyl, two carbons, in imitating root word, two carbon atoms, right? C2H5 is there, alkyl group, ethyl group, OH is present, alcohol group, ethyl alcohol. So, how do you prepare ethyl alcohol? If you want to prepare ethyl alcohol, so the preparation is just take alkene, ethene. I am taking ethene. Okay, if you add some water, water split into H plus ion and OH minus ion, right? In water we have H plus ion, OH ion. So one hydrogen is
added here and another OH is added here. So by breaking this, okay, here H will come and here OH will come. Then in the presence of catalyst it is going on, right? Then it will become CH3, CH2, OH. CH3, CH2 or C2H5 are same. CH3, CH2 or C2H5 give the same end. So that's why this is the preparation of ethyl alcohol. And so what are its properties? If you observe those properties, it is okay. It is colorless. Okay, it has no color. And it is liquid. Ethyl alcohol is a liquid. And its boiling point is 78.3 degrees Celsius. Okay, its boiling point. It gives a pleasant smell. Ethyl alcohol. Right? Ethyl alcohol. 100% is ethyl alcohol is called as 100% is ethyl alcohol. 100% is ethyl alcohol is called as absolute alcohol.
Absolute alcohol. 100% is ethyl alcohol means that there are no impurities. Pure ethyl alcohol is called as absolute alcohol. There are some impurities are present. For example, 5% is ethyl alcohol. 5% is ethyl alcohol means that 5% is impurities are present. 95% is ethyl alcohol is present. For example, okay. So sorry, 95% is 95% is ethyl alcohol. 95% is ethyl alcohol is called as rectified spirit. So 95% is ethyl alcohol present and 5% is impurities are present. 5% is impurities are present. So like that we can explain so the physical properties of ethyl alcohol. What are its chemical properties? Okay, chemical properties. Suppose if it is reacting with metal, then it gives, then it releases hydrogen gas, right? For example, CH3CH2OH. Okay, this is chemical property or chemical properties. In this, if ethyl alcohol react with sodium metal, to balance, take 2 moles here, then so hydrogen can be replaced by sodium metal. Which means that 2 moles of CH2ONA plus H2 gas will be released. This symbol indicates gas. Correct? So H2 gas will be liberated. Like that, it is involved in so different chemical reactions like this. This is one of the important organic compound, that is ethyl alcohol. In this same manner, so we have one more important organic compound, that is ethanoic acid. So this is also called as acetic acid. Another name, it is common name, acetic acid. Right? And its formula CH3COOH. Right? So CH3COOH. It is also colorless. It is also liquid. But gives only unpleasant smell. The smell is not good. Odor means smell. So those are physical properties. And coming to the chemical properties. Acidity. It explains acidity. Acidity means that it always releases H plus ions or hydrogens. Okay, so releasing of H plus ion is called as acidity. For example, here I am taking acetic acid, CH3CH2COOH, and if it is treated with sodium metal,
it is treated with sodium water, then it releases H plus ion and H plus ion not CH2, COH, CH3, COH, COH, it releases H plus ion, so that is CH3, COO, Na plus H2 gas to balance that, just take 2 moles. Okay, to balance the equation, just take 2 moles of acetic acid, 2 moles of sodium, okay, we liberate H2 gas. Okay, here I am reacting with sodium atom. You can also react with base also. For example, here I am taking acetic acid. If I have treated with NaOH, NaOH is called as base. NaOH is called as base. Then what is happening? So here hydrogen, NaOH means that Na plus OH minus ion. So it releases hydrogen as H plus ion. So H plus ion OH minus ion will react together to form H2O molecule. Then COO minus will take Na plus ion and is converted to CH3, COO minus Na plus H2O plus H2O. CH3 COO Na means that COO minus Na plus CO minus. Like that. So it is reacting with base. It is reacting with base. For example, in the same manner, if you take another base like Na to CO3. Na to CO3. Here we have 2 moles of Na. So that's why we are balancing with 2. So then it releases 2 moles of, it is converted to 2 moles of CH3COONa plus CO2 plus H2O plus H2O. Like that, what is happening? It is forming sodium acetate. This is the name of this compound, is sodium acetate. Sodium acetate. Okay, sorry, sodium acetate. Like that, it is reacting. Right? And these are the main chemical properties. And one more reaction we have, so that is esterification. Another important chemical property of this one, esterification. Esterification. So esterification means that formation of ester takes place. Formation of ester. And here R C double bond to OH. This is acid. This is acid. Where R means you can take CH3, you can take C2H1, and so on, you can take C3H7 and so on, in place of R. Right? So if it is reacting with R-OH, R-OH, so this is acid, this is alcohol, this is alcohol, right? In place of R- again you can take CH3, C2H1 and so on like that. When these two are reacting together, okay, when these two are reacting together, here OH, here hydrogens will be eliminated. So hydrogen and OH will be eliminated from this compound. Then we can form a compound like this. We can form a compound that is R, okay, R C double bond O, C double bond O, and O, O is bonded with R dash and O R dash. This is ester. This is ester. You can simply write R C O O R dash. This is condensed form, this is full form, right? R C O O R dash is nothing but ester. So like that we can form ester. So how do you recognize ester? For example, take a beaker in which take a small amount of acid and add small and add some amount of alcohol to that. Alcohol to that. So then just okay, in a beaker I am taking these two. In a beaker I am taking these two. And put on heating, so by the addition of concentrated HCS4, just add concentrated HCS4 to this, add and take another beaker, in which I am making, water. After heating, this, just pour this solution, pour the entire solution. This is liquid, After heating, the entire liquid, if you pour into the water containing beaker, then what is happening? If you smell that, it will give fruity odor, banana juice smell. It gives banana juice smell, which is indicating that formation of ester. If you get such kind of smell, so it is indicating that formation of ester like that. So like that. So
so the proper important property of stick acid is esterification. So formation of ester is called as esterification. Formation of ester. Okay, like that. Okay. So similarly, it is also undergoing. So the formation of ester. Also undergoing. Some bonification reactions. Some bonification reactions means that. So if it is treated with base, again it gives acid and alcohol. It is a reversible reaction. It is a reversible reaction. If ester undergo hydrolysis, right? So along with that, here we have released water, right? So OH and H2O. So released by OH and H2O combine together to form water here. If water and ester combine together, again to give acid and alcohol. Again to give acid and alcohol. Like that, so we can explain. So these chemical properties, right? So those are about, this is about carbon and its carbon.